If you're done practicing on an FPV sim and are now ready to fly real drones, or even if you've already started flying, this video is for you. I'll share some tips and settings that will make your FPV flying experience so much smoother and so much more fun. So without further ado, let's get into it. Tip number 1. Turn on crash recovery in Betaflight by following the method on your screen. This one is really helpful if you're flying a tiny hoop. If your drone bumps into a tree or a wall, your drone will straighten itself out. This means you get more time flying and you waste less time picking up your crashed drone. Tip number 2. You can hold your left and pitch forward to access Betaflight settings on your goggles. Pitch up and down to navigate the menu and right to select. Here's a list of other stick commands that you can use. Tip number 3. Don't use the search button on your goggles to set your video feed. On OSD settings in Betaflight, scroll down on elements and check this VTX channel. Now your channel and band should show up on your OSD. Set your goggles manually. Tip number 4. Diagonal props face the same way. The top left will be the same as the bottom right, and the other way around. Tip number 5. Your drone can get very hot very quickly if it's powered on and not flying. Keep a small fan blowing on it, but don't leave it idle for long. Tip number 6. In VTX settings on Betaflight, turn on low power disarm. Your VTX will run on lowest power settings till you arm it. Final tip is a big one, but very useful. You need to uncheck your mode, save and reboot, then assign it to a switch, and finally, turn on motor stop, save and reboot again. Now with air mode off, your drone's props will not start spinning when you arm, only once you throttle up. You can now take off and land without having your drone go crazy. Before we wrap things up, please drop a comment if you found this useful. Also, subscribe for more.